Hey, welcome back. It's another Mr. Excel podcast. This is Excel Tricks That I Learned at Trainer Talk, episode 1710, the dial chart. Shout out to friends there, Andreas and Dominik, contributed to this idea, and then Dietmar Gieringer actually called me on the phone last night, midnight his time, to walk me through the last little bit that I couldn't get. Check out Dietmar's book, Microsoft Excel 2010, the idea book. That's in German. So today's question came in from Keith. Keith has been in one of my seminars before. He's from Northern Kentucky. Someone sent him a spreadsheet where as you change these percentages here, the dial and the little dial chart moved. This is tough to do, Keith. So we have this dial reading. What we're going to do is create a couple of formulas. The first formula is the dial reading minus 1%. And then the pointer itself is 1%. And then after the pointer is equal 100% or equal 1 minus those two values. So now as we change this dial reading, the percentages change. We're going to create a pie chart from those three values. Just a regular 2D pie will work. You see what we're really interested in here is that orange pointer. So as we change this to 22%, the orange pointer moves. We need to get rid of everything else. So we're going to get rid of the legend. We're going to get rid of the chart title. We can make this a little bit smaller. And then we're going to select the blue series, the before point. First click selects all three series, second click selects just that series. We go out to format and shape fill, no fill. And then over here, the gray series, format, shape fill, no fill. All right, so now we have the pointer working. Let's actually see if we can choose the pointer and format, shape fill. Let's go with a just solid black pointer. So now if you can imagine, the pointer is now pointing at the right spot. So if I go with 77%, it rotates around, right? That's great. The only problem we have, Keith's example, there was actually a circle around that pointer, and so we need to get the circle back. And unfortunately, there's no good way to get the circle back inside the chart. If I turn the shape outline on, then we're also going to have that line at 12 o'clock, which ruins the effect. So we're going to go back to an auto shape. And I have a couple of different ways to do this. Look, I still call it an auto shape, even though they haven't called it that since Excel 2003. First thing, let's go to Insert, Illustrations, Shapes, and choose the oval. Now, a couple of tricks here. If we hold down the Shift key, the oval automatically becomes a circle. So we draw a circle of about the right size outside of the chart. We're going to format that circle, shape outline, black, shape fill, has no fill. So we now have our circle. And I want to get that circle roughly lined up with the chart itself. And here's a trick from Dietmar. If we're going to choose the chart, but not just click on the chart, I want to control click on the chart, which selects the chart container. So that's actually like a shape that contains the chart. And then I'm also going to control click on the circle. So now I've selected two items. With those selected, we'll come out here to the Format tab under the Align Objects, and we're going to align centers and then align middles, which will get that circle dead center hovered over the pie chart. Now, the advantage there that they're centered is it's just a simple matter to resize the circle itself. And if I hold down Control and Shift while I resize, it will draw outwards from the center and resize it till it just reaches the outer edge of the wedge. All right, I think we should have our effect now. Let's try it. We'll just try a few different values here. 35%, 11%, 0%, and we've got the effect. Very difficult set of steps to actually pull this off. And so going back to Keith in Northern Kentucky, he actually had four or five of these set up. Very long, arduous, tedious process, but that certainly is one method to accomplish it. Hey, just as an aside, there might be a different way to do this. If you click the chart, so you can actually see the items in the chart. So now the chart's selected, and we know where the center point is, and we know where the end point is. If we go to Insert, Illustrations, Shapes, and choose the oval while the chart is selected. All right, so now I'm going to hold down Control and Shift, click right on the center point, Control and Shift, and drag outwards to the end of that wedge. This creates an auto shape which actually becomes part of the chart itself. So that might be a slightly easier way to get that circle drawn in. Let's see how it looks here. We'll change the dial reading to 55%. Yeah, it seems like that also works for getting the circle drawn in the right size and location. Well, hey, don't forget to check out TrainerTage, Trainer Days, January 17th through the 21st, 2014, in beautiful Lucerne, Switzerland. Lots of great sessions in Excel, PowerPoint, Word, Access, mostly in German. I will be doing mine in slow English. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.